Welcome to Spotlight ETSU. I'm your host, Carrie Oliveira. Our guests today are DJ Roberts-Jesse, who's a lecturer in the Communication Department, and Martin Becerra, a graduate student at ETSU and the president of Buck Films. First, let me introduce you to DJ Roberts-Jesse. Hi, DJ.
Good morning.
How are you? I'm well. Thank you so much for being here. I'm so excited, especially because of what you're here to talk to us about.
Yes.
So just some little background on you. You've been with the ETSU Department of Communication teaching advertising classes for how long now?
15 years.
Good long time. And you've sent many of our students out into the world as practicing advertising professionals, yes?
Yes, I have. And it's I'm proud I have them all over the world, everywhere from Beijing, China, to San Francisco, to New York, to Chattanooga. So yes.
That is fabulous. You are going to talk to us today about sort of another way to help your students get out into the world and be excellent at practicing professionals or whatever it is they choose to do, with a new study abroad opportunity that's being launched in the fall.
Right.
In association with John Cabot University in Rome, Italy.
Yes.
So tell me about this program.
John Cabot University. We're calling it here ETSU at John Cabot University in Rome.
Oh, I love that.
It's a wonderful opportunity for our students. We're launching this new class fall of this year. Mm-hmm. John Cabot University is a liberal arts American University in Rome, in Testevere, which is one of the oldest sections of Rome, right across the Tiber River from the Pantheon, and about 15-minute walk from St. Peter's.
Whoa, that just blew my mind. I get to go to school across, like, across the street, basically, from the Pantheon.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes.
Okay.
So it's an amazing place. We were able to, through friendships and networking that I did here in Johnson City, a dear friend of mine, Lisa Rowland, who spent a lot of time and actually grew up in Europe and spent a lot of time in Rome, mm-hmm. has a friend who is the vice provost, if you will, for John Cabot. And through a dinner conversation last year, and I was listening to the program and what all it had to offer, and he said, you know, we're always reaching out to other universities to offer some sort of study abroad opportunities.
The folks from John Cabot want students from all over the place to come to them.
Yes, they do.
This is part of their mission.
This is part of their mission. It has been for about the last 5 years. They were a very, very small liberal arts college, and they catered to kind of Ivy League schools. Mm-hmm. And then they realized that while they could want to continue to do that, these Ivy League schools, these students generally get to travel.
Yes.
Their parents have prominence or have the wherewithal to be able to let them travel. And so they've changed their mission to say, you know, really the students that we want to attract here are students that wouldn't normally be able to travel abroad, or who don't think that a study abroad for an entire semester is within their capability. So they have really reached out.
That's awesome.
It is.
So
it's
exciting.
Amazing. It's for us to be able to launch this and to be able to offer students at ETSU an opportunity to take an entire semester and go study in Rome at an American university. It's accredited.
Mm-hmm.
The professors all speak English, even though they are from all over the country and all over the world. So the students don't need to know Italian,
right.
Even though we would hope that once they're there, that they would just, you know, they would just absorb all of that culture.
I would surely hope that spending 16 weeks in Italy, you would pick up something of Italian.
It's just an opportunity, and I came back with this excitement in this program, and met with Dean Piles, and of mm-hmm. course with Dr. Bach, and said, "Is there something we can do here?" And both of them, I've been just so amazingly supported, said, let's go to work. And so at this point, we have six programs.
Six individual, like, major programs of study.
Major programs, right, which includes advertising,
right.
PR, marketing, of course. I was going to take care of my students.
Of course.
Of course. And, of course, we have art history, and we have English, and we have history, and we have political science. And those folks have all signed up and gone on board. And we have six programs of study, plus we've been able to go back through our gen ed and find a whole slew of courses. And so that basically means any student that comes to ETSU has an opportunity to go study abroad for an entire semester. They can either finish their gen ed there.
Right.
Or if they belong to one of these programs that we have so far, and we have others that are looking at the syllabi, et cetera, to see if they can make these credits transferable.
Right.
Those six areas of program really opens it up to every student here on campus.
That's an incredibly important thing to note. I was talking to one of our majors in communication studies like last week or earlier this week, and he wants to do a study abroad. He hasn't decided what country he wants to go to, but part of the challenge in talking to students who want to do study abroad is trying to figure out, how do I not, and I hate to use this word, but how do I not waste a semester when I can't be sure that the courses I'm going to be taking at whatever university I'm at aren't ever going to transfer or whatever else, trying to find things in your program of study, especially if they've already finished their gen ed, things like this. And so really there's a logistical problem with a lot of our study abroad programs where students are taking courses that may or may not actually count toward degree completion.
Right.
So as much as you're getting a really wonderful experience abroad, there's always a mindfulness about making sure that the degree gets done.
Well, especially in today's environment where we're so cost conscious of the cost of education.
Right.
So every semester hour needs to count.
Yes.
And while, like you said, it's not necessarily a waste to go study abroad, but to know that, and we have worked, I mean, when I say we, I'm talking about Dean Piles and Bert Bach and a lot of other people here on this campus to go through all of John Cabot's syllabi mm-hmm. and their credit courses and say, we will guarantee
right.
that if you take this list of courses, they are all transferable.
Basically created a transfer articulation agreement with
sure.
a university in Italy. That's
at a university in Italy.
Too fabulous.
And what's also, I think, very important too is that making Gen Ed available
yes.
is very important, because sometimes students, especially in the hard sciences or other areas, once they get into that realm of their junior and senior
yep.
year, it becomes difficult to take time to do this sort of thing because their classes are only offered certain times
yep.
or they're
in a particular rotation.
Yes.
Yeah, all that.
So this means that any student can do this at ETSU. And to open that up, you and I were talking earlier, ETSU has some amazing things happening on this campus right now.
Big stuff.
Big projects. We've got our football program. We've got the Performing and Fine Arts Center. We've got big things that people are talking about. But I think it's so important that the students here know, and also their families and the greater community understand, we are constantly working to improve the academic performance here for ETSU.
Yes.
We're trying to create offerings. This study abroad, this semester study abroad, came about because of the 125 committees of last year, just
right.
like the Fine and Performing Arts Center, just like the football program. And what we had was industry come in and say, your students are fabulous. We love hiring them. What they lack, though, in today's environment is an international perspective
that they've gotten by way of interacting internationally.
Right. Right.
We can teach some of that theoretically in the classroom, but it's a very different thing than to interact internationally and then bring that perspective back into industry.
Oh, sure. I mean, you know, when you get off of a flight in Rome at 8:30 in the morning and it's 2:30 in the morning your time
mm-hmm.
and you have to negotiate getting into a cab and getting somewhere, you recognize that there's no way you can prepare for that in the classroom.
No.
That's just you got to get out there, roll up your sleeves, and do it. And the ability to do that and the confidence level of doing that is unbelievable. And that's what industry came back and said. And so we did it. We said, okay, we hear you. And now we are offering this opportunity to students. Whether or not they take it, you know, we're hoping that they will. And we've done a lot of things to make sure that they see that there is a value to this.
That was where I was going to move the conversation next. So two things I wanted to talk about is there's a lot of research that's been done on study abroad programs and what benefit they provide to a student.
Right.
And so you cite some research is when you're talking to students about availing themselves to a study abroad. So students who go abroad have higher GPAs, they're more likely to graduate. Is that what the statistics are showing us, in fact?
The statistics, and this has been done nationally by a lot of other colleges,
right.
not just ours. But statistically, students that go and study abroad have higher GPAs.
Mm-hmm.
Their test scores are generally higher by significant proportions. And I think the most important one, and I'm going to read this one so I don't screw it up, is that the graduation rates. This was a study done in 2009 by Indiana University, and they said that the graduation rates for 6 years of graduation, okay, right. Improves from 68.5% more likely to graduate to 95.3% more likely to graduate.
Was that just at their university, or did they collect data across the country?
Across the country.
So an average national graduation rate of about 68%, but increased to 95% for those students who went to study abroad.
Sure, sure.
It's almost a guaranteed graduation if you
choose to go abroad. It's like being plugged into an IQ machine. I mean,
right.
It's like all of a sudden I get it.
Yes.
And that's basically what this data I think shows, is that the students go and they collaborate and they work with people from all over the world. Going back to John Cabot, mm-hmm. it's 1,000 students.
1,000 students in the entire university.
Right, and it's a charming campus. It's, you know, it's in a 200-year-old a convent. It's just the gardens are beautiful. I mean, it's hard to explain how stunning it is, but the faculty are international also.
Right.
One third of the students that go are Italian, one third are American, and one third are from the EU or from other continents. So that means that your class sizes are generally going to be between 20 and 25 students. Well, when you take a political class or you take a history class and you're standing there next to students that are from Egypt, that are from Bulgaria, mm-hmm. that are from Canada, that are from, you know, Kansas, you get a worldwide perspective,
yes.
that people can basically get involved in the conversation and go, wait a minute.
Right.
I'm not going to tell you something that's written in a book. I'm going to tell you how it was the day that happened. They quoted an experience to me with a student who was there during the Egypt Spring.
Mm-hmm.
and Americans were talking about, oh, yes, and this happened, because we saw it on CNN. And he said, well, let me tell you my perspective. When I woke up in the morning and walked through the streets and watched all, and had my mother and I had to clean up all the animals that had been butchered the night before and left on doorsteps for those of us that were, you know, the counterinsurgency.
Yeah.
And he said, you know, that kind of conversation changes
the humanization of history is something that can only happen when you're talking to people who are actually
sure.
living there.
Sure.
We have a couple minutes left in the conversation. Tell me about what resources students have to be able to pay for such an experience. Right? People think that study abroads are significantly more expensive than paying tuition regularly. You guys have done a lot of work to make sure that is not the case.
Well, first of all, let me just say that because of student fees, and we talk about student fees, but we have student fees here that go directly to the International Education Scholarship.
Yes.
Which is worth up to $5,000, okay? So
okay.
a student can get up to $5,000. On top of that, we've had two anonymous donors come forward and say, for those students that perhaps are financially challenged but have a GPA of at least 3.25, we're going to sweeten the pot with another $1,000 scholarship. So that's up to $6,000 in scholarship.
Are these competitive scholarships? I mean, aside from the fact that you need to meet the GPA requirement and demonstrate financial need, is there, like, if you're looking for 10 students to go in the cohort in the upcoming year, would all 10, if they met the GPA requirement,
yes.
be able to collect that extra $1,000?
Yes, yes.
Outstanding.
Yes. So we don't have a cutoff, let's put it that way.
Okay.
On top of that, John Cabot University has given us a 10% discount on our tuition.
Okay.
So right now, let's just say ballpark, we're looking at $9,675 just for the classes, okay, just for the semester at John Cabot. ETSU is running a little over $7,000.
Right.
Now, there are some out-of-pocket costs,
sure.
obviously, the
plane tickets,
insurance, some things like that.
Yeah.
But overall, we have made this very, very competitive. And so we're just excited about this program. It's an opportunity to grow. Plus, think about coming back to ETSU,
yes.
and giving that experience to the classroom.
Right, it doesn't just stay with you, but it becomes part of the way that you engage the rest of your educational experience, and you bring all of that into the environment where you're learning here in Johnson City, and you're going to take it with you wherever else you go.
Plus, in a world that's gone global, you need global
networking.
You need
to be global.
And you need to be able to bring those things back to our community.
DJ, this has been fabulous, and I'm so excited about this. I really hope that you manage to get your incoming cohort. We're going to take a little break. When we come back, we are going to spend some time with Martin Becerra, who is going to talk to us about Buck Films and a sitcom he's shooting for his thesis. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
In the small town of Elmira, New York.